So Frank, thanks so much for giving me a couple of minutes to talk about this new, fascinating, exciting project. So let me start by asking, although you don't share a lot of scenes, obviously I'm not going to spoil anything. You don't share a lot of scenes with Shay and Olivia, but were they factors that made you decide to participate in this film?
Shay was certainly. Shay and I have known each other since we did Pride and Glory together, I don't know how many years ago, and we've often collaborated on things, and he called me up, and that's all I needed is for him to say, come, I want you to be in this movie with me, and I was there. You know, I've said it 1,000 times, I think he's one of the best actors working today.
You have like this charisma that not many actors have that while playing a villain. It is pleasant, and many times we even sympathize with your characters when they, you know, when they're on the bad side of the law. So what was it like creating a character that would connect with audience and making it credible when your scenes, at least in this movie, are somehow limited?
Yeah, I'm not in the movie that much, and that's a great question. And you know, I always do like to try to find a way for there to be empathy for whatever characters I'm playing, because otherwise you're just kind of a one-dimensional villain. And for me, I think there's something charming about the way he dresses, the way he really does love the people in his world. And he does have a philosophy in life that is interesting to listen to. You know, he's also a teacher to these other. And I think all of that, take away the violence, it makes him a good guy. It kind of makes him, there's a lot of elements of him that are decent. And yet he's not. So, but thank you for saying so. That means I did my job.
Yeah. you did it great, awesome. It was an awesome performance. So I was working with Michelle. I believe this is his second feature length film. So I was working after working with so many great experienced directors. I was working with Michelle.
Yeah, I got to tell you, and I've worked with some inexperienced directors, and the result has not been the same. But he really he's an old soul, and he really has an understanding cinematically of what he wants, not only from the characters, but from how the movie should look and feel. And he seems like a far more seasoned director. And I think, look, I would work with him every time, and I think he's gonna have a great career.
I agree 100% with you. I love the film, I love his style, and it's kind of different. It looks very, although it was urban gritty drama, it also has like a fresh take on the genre.
Yeah.
So if you had to choose something that you want people to take away from this movie when they go see it, what would it be?
Yeah, I think hope. I think, you know, like there is hope in humanity, because we live in a time now, I tell you, you know, Felix, what's going on, you know, you turn on the news, from COVID to all the problems, from the governor of New York to Afghanistan, it all becomes so dark and sour, and you question people, and I think there's an element of this film where it's like, okay, it's okay, like people can be okay.
A great answer, and thank you for that. So you are extremely active this year. You only have, I think, there are like 8 projects coming out to 2021. So how do you move from one character to another? Do you have any process to disconnect from one character to the next one?
Yeah, and look, to me, characters in movies are like meals. Once I'm finished, I don't think about it anymore, and I'm on to the next. You know, I'm not an actor who, like, you know, Brad Pitt, you know, you can make one movie a year and make $20 million and life's good. I not only do I love working, but I also have to support my family. So I keep going.
Excellent. Excellent. Thank you for that. My time's up. And again, thank you for such a wonderful performance. I love the film. And again, stay safe, whatever you are. And thank you. Thank you very much for your career.
Thanks, Felix.
Thank you, Frank. Have a great day.